What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. 2017 F250 6.7 Powerstroke. Customer says that it feels like the engine's missing. Let's get in here and take a look at it. All right, we're in here, 92,244 miles. The wrench light is on, the check engine light is on, and I can feel this thing shaking. So let's get over here to the trusty computer and start a new session and see what is going on. If we have an injector imbalance or if we got a fuel system issue. Yes. And see if we can get this customer fixed up and on his way. Man, this thing's shaking like crazy. It's not good. So we're gonna wait for this to do its little thing. And then we are going to go up here to the toolbox. We see my finger. And we are going to pull some codes. Man, this thing's bouncing. It feels like it's cammed. That's what it feels like. Just rocking back and forth. Just sitting here at idle. We're gonna see if we can get them all fixed up. And still doing the network test. All right, cool. Self-test. Yes. All? Yes. Let's see what we come up with here. Reading continuous DTCs, diagnostic trouble codes. And it is performing a self-test on all the modules that are on the truck. And they'll pop up right here and we'll be able to go from there. I wonder if he's got a bad injector. We'll find out here shortly. And if he does have a bad injector, see if he wants to replace it. And we can also see why this wrench light is on. C manual. Okay. Pretty truck. All right, what we got here? What we got? Scroll down. 305. Cylinder 5 misfire detected. Customer was right. 1265. Cylinder 5 high to low side short. Okay. TCM invalid data received from ECM. All right, so we got a misfire on cylinder 5. And then we got a cylinder 5 high to low short. So let's go take a look at the injectors. Cylinder 5 is going to be the back one. Or excuse me, 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 is going to be the front one on the driver's side. So let's go take a look. All right, number 5, right there with that red tab. From the looks of it, the wires look okay. They don't look chewed up, anything like that. Which, that wire actually runs up underneath there, you can see it right here, into this big harness right there, right above that fuel rail. So I'm going to go through the pinpoint test. Okay, here we are. P0305, cylinder 5 misfire detected. Possible causes: damaged fuel injector or base engine concerns. It says go to pinpoint test AR. Let's go to pinpoint test AR. It says pinpoint test is intended to diagnose a fuel injector. Are the DTCs? Yep, R305 is right there. Yes, go to AR3. If I can get my mouse to move. All right, are there any non-misfire continuous DTCs? No. Carry out the PCM. Key on engine off self-test. Key on engine run self-test. All right. Key on engine off self-test. On the PC. Self-test. Enter. Come on. That's not what I wanted to do. Why did I do that? Okay, key on, engine off, on demand, self-test. Key on, engine off. Performing test. It's probably going to have me push a bunch of buttons. I'm not even worried about that right now. Self-test in progress. Do-do-do. 305. So key on, engine off, passed. Let's look at the freeze frame. It happened with 192 degree, 45% load, 59 miles an hour. Okay. Exit. Self-test. Modules. PCM, key on, engine running. And it's gonna give me that misfire code. I can feel it. Press and release the brake pedal. Yeah. Tow haul mode. You don't feel it when it's got throttle, only feel it when it's at idle. I'm willing to bet the injector is bad. Pretty common on these. Doing its test. Anyway, if you guys have a power stroke that you need to get worked on, please send me an email. Come see me. I will be more than happy to work on your power stroke for you and get you fixed up the correct way, much like we are doing with this customer here. Yeah, it's smooth. It's smooth when it's up in RPMs. But as soon as it drops down to idle, it's going to start shaking really bad. So I'm leaning toward bad injector, but we're going to finish this pinpoint test. Yep, starting to shake again. Shaky. It's like a massage chair. So key on, engine run, got a 305 and a 1265. Cylinder 5, high to low side short. So we'll look at that code too. Okay, remember that 1265 came up and it told me to disregard the 305 and go to the 1265, cylinder 5, high to low. So the possible causes are injector 5 circuit short circuit, injector 5 short to ground, injector 5 short to voltage, or damaged fuel injector. Let's go to pinpoint test P. All right, harness, fuel injector, or the PCM. Let's go carry out the injector electrical self-test. Carry out the key on, engine off. Already did that. Carry out the key on, engine run. Are there any DTCs received? Those two were not. All others were going to go to that. But we need to go to the electrical self-test. So let's electrical self-test. Exit out of here. Go up here, self-test, modules, I hate that I can't do it that way, PCM, key on, engine off. Key on, engine off, electrical self-test. Doink. 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 Performing test. And it's going to do its thing again. I'm still leaning toward a bad injector. Select item for more information. Okay, that didn't help. Anyway. All others go to P2. So the injector return, positive lead, suspect fuel injector connector, refer to wiring cell. I'm going to ohm it out, injector component side. So component side, component side. I'm basically ohming out the injector. See, component side. And I need 150,000 ohms to 210,000 ohms. All right, we're set on ohms. All right, I'm gonna try to set this where you guys can see it. Not right there. You see that? Okay. And all I'm gonna do is go down there and touch. I need to go down here and touch the connector prongs, if I can see them. Something like that. And there's one, kind of a tight spot. One. I'm trying to make it where you guys can see. Hmm. 142. Come on. I think we got a bad injector, guys. So if you look right here, is the resistance between 150,000 and 210 ohms? No, and I'm not a transit. Right here, install a new fuel injector. So let's go get a quote on a fuel injector. Now see, I showed you how to check the component down there, but there's actually another way you can do it. Pull the middle PCM connector. This bottom row is your injectors. So injector number 5 is the 5th one over, right? So I got it on power and ground. And let me hook that. See, now it says open because I got nothing connected. I did plug it in back over there. Plug this back, touch it. Let me switch hands. So we're out of range. Bad injector. That's another way you can do it. And to prove it to you, I have it set up on another one so I can show you what a good one looks like. Let me set this up, the camera. All right, so that one's just in another one. Ooh. Stick this one in the pin next to it, which is that guy right there. If I can get this to stop moving. .9. See if I can put it somewhere where you can see it. There you go. That's a good one. Okay, so I got the injector out. It's right there. And now I can ohm it without being tucked in there, even though I showed you two ways to do it. So I'm looking for 150,000 to 210,000 ohms of resistance. And now that I got it out, I can show you what it is. Okay, set on ohms. There's my injector. I'm just gonna touch the pins. You guys watch over here. Oh, look at that. .6. So that's not where it's supposed to be. So yeah, there's the injector. It's bad. So there's two ways you can test the injector: by unplugging it, going down there and ohming it out, or coming over here and finding which correct pin it's supposed to be, ohming it out that way. I got the same when I pinned it over here and it was plugged in. I got 4-point-something ohms, and then as the same as I did while I was over on the toolbox. A little hard to get down there by itself, but the injector will be here tomorrow morning. I went ahead and got it out. That way I got to just put the new one in and code it, and then clear the codes, and then when I say coded, I mean IQA code. Then other than that, customer will be good to go. I appreciate it. Love you guys. I'll see you on the next one.